Okay, so for the foundation, something that's kind of a misconception, I think, for the fall makeup trends is a lot of people will tend to go for more matte foundations and have their skin looking very matte and no, like, glowiness or shimmer or whatever. I just say scrap that. I think it's really nice to just throughout the whole year to have a really nice glowy look to your skin. So first of all, I just applied a nice foundation. I put powder, but then I also sprayed Avène. Some kind of thermal water spray stuff on it. It's basically just water. You can use MAC Fix Plus or anything similar to that. So that'll just give your face more of a dewy look, but not really oily or anything like that. So the palette, I'm going to be using a Wet n Wild eyeshadow palette for the whole eye look pretty much. And this is their large palette in Paradise Cove, and I believe this is still available. So it's just got these awesome colors. It's perfect for fall. I really like it. So first of all, what we're going to do is apply a highlight. I'm going to use this light peach here in my big eyeshadow brush, and I already applied an eyeshadow base. Okay. So I just want to start under the brow and then blend down. Then you just want to kind of blend whatever's left over right on the lid. Okay. Alright, so next the color we're going to use is, you can use either the purple on the top or the burgundy color underneath it. I'm going to choose to use the purple for this specific look, and it doesn't look like I've even touched this before. So we'll see. This is actually really good quality eyeshadow. Yeah, it's really nice. Alright, and we're just going to put this on the lid. And it is pretty sheer, so depending on how dark your skin is, you may want to apply it wet or just layer it a lot. You just want to take it right into the crease. Okay, so just like that. Alright, so next we're going to use this nice, cool taupe color right here. And with my tapered blending brush, just want to get that right in the brush. Oh wow, I just hit the pan. Cool. Hitting the pan, by the way, means where you can see the silver of the eyeshadow pan underneath the actual shadow. Alright, so with this, you're just going to look kind of straight into the mirror, shut your eye, and wherever that crease is, you just want to start there and just blend it out. And with this, you're first just going to concentrate right here in the top of the eye. And then you just want to kind of blend it out a little bit. And out here, we're going to go out. Just like that, not too much. And then just kind of bring it down in that V shape on the outer corner. Okay, and then you just want to take what's left over and just blend it right into the inner corner here. Okay, and then we're just going to blend this top part out just a little bit. Alright, so that's what that's going to look like. Alright, so now you're just going to take a really stiff, some kind of liner or stiff small eyeshadow brush, and just pick up some more of that same color. And we're going to run this under the eye to kind of create that smoky look, which is still popular. Sorry, I guess I just get sort of annoyed when like the same look is popular for like, I don't know how long it's been, 2 years now or something. But that's okay. I mean, I guess new things are coming in too, so. So you want to take it pretty far down. Okay. All right, so now you just want to wipe off that brush a little bit. And we're going to go into this really deep brown on the bottom there. And with this, we're just going to take it right in the outer crease. And then you just want to blend it a little bit, kind of little circle motions. This brush isn't the best for blending, so we might go back with a different one. Alright, so the last part for the eyes, other than mascara, is I'm going to use a gel, I think it's what it's called, yeah, a gel eyeliner. I'm using Jane Be Pure Mineral Gel Liner in Wine, so it's a nice purple color that will go along with that shadow we used. And the brush I'm going to use is just this real cheapy, slanted one that's actually really good quality. I bought this at Walmart. So I'm just going to apply that along the top lash line and just wing it out just a touch on the end. Okay, so now you just want to apply some nice black mascara. I'm using Full and Soft, and make sure you curl your lashes first if you need to. And then I'm just going to do my brows and come back and show you the cheeks and lips. Okay, it looks like it's probably getting dark, so I'll try to make this quick. For the cheeks, what I'm going to use is, once again, drugstore. Everything I'm using is drugstore. I'm using Jane Be Pure Mineral Blush in Soft Mink. So I'm just going to use my contouring blush brush. Let's see, where do I want to put this? Okay, I want to put this right on the cheekbone. Just like this. Okay. I love this blush, it's so pretty. Okay, so now just wipe off that brush a little bit and then pick up my Prestige highlighter. I'll put the name, title, whatever in the box because it's so long. And then you're just gonna put this right on the inner parts of the apples and then run it right on top of the cheekbones. And then just kind of blend it all out. Okay, and for lips, I'm going to use Revlon Super Lustrous in Nude Luster. Alright, so here's my finished kind of go-to fall makeup look. I kind of, you know, just kind of mixed up different things that I do very often. So yeah, hopefully you guys like it. It's kind of a mixed color smoky eye, I guess you could say. And then just neutral cheeks and lips, two of my favorite colors for fall neutrals. So yeah, thanks you guys for watching and subscribing, and I will see you all later.